Hello children, I welcome all of you in today's English session. So, in today's session, we are going to see module 4 in your English grammar and composition book. First exercise is sentence dictation. You have to frame 5 sentences and write them here. Then, in second exercise, there are few questions related to Earth. With the help of your EVS 2 book or with the help of other sources, you can read the questions and choose the correct option for those questions. So children, now we are going to see how to use a dictionary. In dictionary, you can see this is picture of a single page. So this is page number and you will see that here's one word harvest, while there's another word hasty. Now children, these two words tell us that this page starts from harvest word and end with hasty word. So now the words coming between harvest and hasty are mentioned here. These words are called guide words. These words are called guide words. And here you will see that all the words are arranged in alphabetical order. All the words are arranged in alphabetical order from page 1 till last page. Now, given below are guide words on a page of dictionary. Birth, 12, blade. You have to go on page number 12 and find the guide words birth and blade. Then, when you go to this page, you have to tick the words that you find on this page. Blow, blanket, blind, blank, biscuit, balloon. So, whichever words you find on this page or from birth to blade, you have to tick for those words. And the words that you won't find on that page, you have to put a cross on that word. Then, here's one word, biodegradable. You have to make 6 words using the letters of the words. Write those 6 words here. Then later on, you have to arrange these words in alphabetical order. So, first of all, find any 6 words or make any 6 words using these letters. And then arrange them in alphabetical order. Now we are going to see pronouns. So children, we know that pronouns are the words that are used instead or in place of noun. Noun, naming word. So pronouns are used instead of naming words. Till class 4, we have seen subject pronouns. Subject pronouns, they perform the action in a sentence. They perform the action in a sentence like I, we, you, he, she, it, they. Object pronouns, they receive the action in a sentence. Me, us, you, him, her, it, them. Reflexive pronouns, they are used when we refer to subject of the sentence again. They are himself, myself, yourself or yourselves, himself, herself, itself, ourselves. Then we have also seen possessive pronouns. They show ownership. Mine, yours, his, hers, ours, its, theirs. Now, today we are going to see new type of pronoun, that is relative pronoun. So, relative pronoun point out which person or thing is being talked about. In this relative pronoun, this relates to the noun. Relative pronoun point out which person or thing is being talked about. Then, relative pronouns are who, whom, whose, which, when, where, that. It means that all the relative pronouns are WH type words. WH means where, what, when, why, whom, whose, who. These all words begin with WH. So, we say them as WH type of words. Relative pronouns are WH type of words. Now, choose the correct pronoun for each sentence and fill in the blanks. I could not find out whose pen it was. You are given three options, who, whose, whom, and you have to select one of it. Your school is much bigger than dash, our, ours, us. Your school is much bigger than ours. Dash switched off the fan before she left the room. She switched off the fan before she left the room. Have you seen Samir? I think this bag is his. My uncle is talking, taking us to the museum. We ate up all mangoes by ourselves. Now here in this question, you have to use correct relative pronouns. So, I saw the girl who ate the cake. We did not know the tune dash had been played. We did not know the tune that had been played. I have a friend dash cat is cute. I have a friend whose cat is cute. This is the place dash we met. This is the place where we met. Puneet is the man to dash who whom this watch belongs. Puneet is the man to whom this watch belongs. The car dash was green drove by. The car which was green drove by. Then in next question you will see a bracket, relative, object, possessive, reflexive and subject. These all are types of pronouns. Now here are few sentences. You have to write down the type of pronoun for the underlined word in each. Then you have to write another sentence using same pronoun. The stadium where the match took place was renovated 2 months ago. Now, where is relative pronoun? Using this word, using this type of pronoun or word where, you will make another sentence. That is the cave where the thief hid. I had forgotten my bottle, but she had got hers. Now, word underlined is hers. You have to guess the type of pronoun. And using that word or type of pronoun, you have to make another sentence. Now, we are going to see message writing. Whenever we give a message, the message has three parts, salutation or greeting, then body of the message, and last is signature. Salutation of the greeting. How you address the person depends on how close you are. Like if it's friend, you can say dear Sanjana. If you are giving a message to teacher, it should be respected sir or ma'am. Then body of the message. Whatever message you want to give, that should be the body. Keep it short and to the point. Then signature. How you sign off also depends on how close you are to the person. Now here is, it may be her sister or friend Sanjana. So we can write here your loving friend. Then if you are writing giving message to your parents, you can write your lovingly. If you are giving message to teacher, it should be your obediently or sincerely. In this way, you will write a message to your mother thanking her for taking you to an aqua and fish exhibition. Complete the message with the help of outline given below. So, this is the message. Dear Ma, I can't tell you how happy dash. In this way, you will fill these blanks and write your own message. Diary writing. Diary is a book in which one can write about the things that happen in everyday life. Now, while writing a diary, the diary should have four parts. Salutation or greeting, day and date, contents of the diary entry and signature. So, day and date is very important when you are writing a diary. As you know that we are writing day-to-day incidents in this diary. So, the date should be mentioned very clearly. Then salutation or greeting. Dear diary, now you are writing thanks to your diary. So it is mentioned dear diary. Then you have to write the content and afterwards your signature. In this way, you have to imagine that you have visited a new place and you are writing about it in a diary. Use the hints given below to help you write your diary entry. So, using hints, you will write your diary on this page number 47. And complete your module 4 in neat and clean handwriting. Thank you. Bye.